have this strange looking structure on the ground. So this, we're gonna have a cistern here. Once you go in a door on the side here, it's gonna go down 2 or 3 feet. And from here, this is where all the plumbing's gonna be. We're gonna have radiant and floor heating. We're gonna have the electricity. But then this round structure right here, it's gonna be 9 feet in diameter on the inside and 7 feet deep. It's a 3,000 gallon rainwater cistern. So that will be an interesting part of this house. This will also double as a storm shelter. Being partway underground, having a curved structure in here is gonna make the walls extra strong. Alright, so here we are inside the 3,000 gallon rainwater cistern that's going to be the water supply for the house. And the cistern's all made out of earth bags. You can't see them right now because it's all the walls all covered with papercrete. And the papercrete that we use inside here is basically we're mixing 15 pounds of newspaper with 20 pounds of Portland cement, 20 pounds of sand, and about a cup of borax to help prevent any mildew moisture issues, since we are down here in the cistern. This covering has helped bring, if we just had the bags here, you'd have all the grooves here, and to smooth it out a little bit and insulate things a little bit, that's when we went ahead and put this on the walls. All right, and what we have, in total there's gonna be about 3,000 gallons of rainwater storage here. We have, this space is 9 feet in diameter by 7 feet high. And up there we have what's going to be, there's going to be a 3-inch pipe coming in there to attach to the cistern liner that will be installed here before long. And that's our emergency overflow drain. And down here below my feet, this is what I've been working on today. A lot of this papercrete had fallen down into the gravel as I sprayed on the walls. Next time I'll put something on the ground to help clean it up a little bit better. But we scooped a lot of the gravel out that had all the papercrete mixed in and tossed it over on the driveway. The problem with this papercrete, if it's mixed in with the gravel too much, the papercrete can absorb moisture and wick it up into the walls and cause some other issues. So after we clean out the contaminated gravel, we brought in fresh gravel, and we've got about 5 inches below our feet right here. Actually, it depends on where you're standing. Should have at least 4 to 6 inches as a cathodic break to prevent moisture from coming up from underneath. So on the outer walls here, you can see the laser level I was using this morning. The outer edges, the difference between the outer edges and the very center is that the center is 3 inches deeper than the outer sections. So the water pump, cistern pump, is going to be right in the center here. The next layer, I found an old beat up blue tarp. It was time to retire it. Put that on top of the gravel, and then use some 6 mil plastic, a double layer of this, to also help prevent moisture from coming up from underneath. Styrofoam here is good insulation, but it's also going to make something soft for the cistern liner to rest on without creating any issues there. And in the gaps here, you can see that I'm filling it with this spray foam. So I know styrofoam's for an earth-friendly the building, the least friendly part about this is probably the styrofoam. But at least, you know, I'm getting one of the three R's there, the reduce, reuse, recycle. Well, in this case, we're reusing the styrofoam I've come across on Craigslist. Originally, this is actually the third time most of this is being used. And it was in someone's attic originally. The person I bought it from, it was in an outbuilding at a property he bought. And he didn't want it on the walls anymore. And so I got a whole truckload of this. This is what's going around the foundation, around the entire house. And these are all the leftover pieces. I kind of planned this from the beginning, saving all the little cuts and scraps so that I can piece it together here and make a nice floor for the cistern.